How to save our iman? We know how important to save our iman. Iman is the most valuable thing in akhirah. In akhirah, Allah is not going to check how much money you have, how many children you have, how many wives you have. But what Allah is going to ask you is about your iman. So take care of our iman. How to do that? Do whatever Allah wants you to do. Whatever the Prophet wants you to do, and stay away from muharramat. That is thing that is haram, and what the Prophet say no, you said no. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Innal hamdalillah نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وبعد الأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محددة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أو كما قال Dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, we have begun this morning talk by wishing all of you may the peace of Allah and His mercy and blessing be upon us all. Amen. This morning do not mean anything to all of us if we do not begin our day by asking Allah to bless our morning and our evening. I would like to call upon all the brothers and sisters who are with us today. Let us make a short dua together. Not only I recite and you say Ameen, but let us recite the prayer together so that all of us will be blessed by Allah. I'm going to guide you slowly in this dua, and we hope everyone who are here will follow me in reciting this short dua. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بك أصبحنا وبك أمسينا وبك نحيا وبك نموت وإليك النشور Raise up your voice, brothers and sisters. بسم الله الذي لا يدر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد النبي وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الحمد لله رب العالمين آمين يا رب العالمين. We ask Allah to bless our morning because we need Allah's blessing. We ask Allah to keep on blessing our evening because we still need His blessing. And we ask Allah to bless our living because we want to live with the blessing of Allah, not just live for the sake of living. Like animals, like people who disbelieve Allah, they live, but they live for the sake of living for dunya, not for akhirah. But we live here for akhirah. Because the Prophet said, "Ad-dunya khuliqat lakum, walakinnakum khuliqat lil akhirah." This world is made by Allah to serve us. We are made by Allah to go to akhirah, not for dunya. We ask Allah to make us all Muslim prepared. Prepared to go back to Allah, because sooner or later we are going to die. Nobody will live forever. Whether you are young, you are old, you are healthy, you are sick, you are rich, you are poor, everybody is going to die. كل نفس ذائقة الموت. Every living thing will perish. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us that we will never die until we become a mu'min, until we become a Muslim. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Make sure that none of us depart from this world until we have submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we live one, we'll die one. Only once. Only one chance. There's no way for you to say, "Oh Allah, give me another chance." No more. So make sure that you choose the right way to die. Don't die for dunya. Don't die for people. Don't die for your job. Don't die for your business. Don't die because of your wife, because of your husband, because of your children. Make sure that وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Make sure that إِنَّ الصَّلَاتِ وَنُسُكِ وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ. For who? Lil. Say, إِنَّ الصَّلَاتِ وَنُسُكِ وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ Rabbil Alamin. Amin ya Rabbil Alamin. Fellow brothers and sisters, today, before I continue, we know how important to save our iman. Iman is the most valuable thing in akhirah. In akhirah, Allah is not going to check how much money you have. Allah is not going to ask you how many children you have, how many wives you have. Allah is not going to ask you that. Allah is not going to check your degree, your diploma, whether you are a doctor, your BA holder, MA, PhD. No, He is going to ask you anything of that. But what Allah is going to ask you is about your iman. And the topic today is how to save our iman. I want the brothers especially, please respond. When I ask you something, respond. Yeah, respond to me, please. Do we all have iman now? Are we mu'min? I don't hear you. Are you mu'min? Yes. You must express yourself. Don't hide. Yeah, I think so. Not what you think so. Of course, we are mu'min. Are we mu'min? Alhamdulillah. This expression is important. We want to express ourselves so that the world know that we are mu'min. It's important. Do you think we need to save our iman? Yes. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. How can you save your iman? How can we save our iman? Inshallah. I will share with you now. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam remind us with one saying. I'm going to remind you again and again. Every time when I give lecture to all my Muslim brothers and sisters, I always remind them. Why? Because they are not responding to this call. Even after reminding them, they forgot again. They keep on forgetting. And there is our nature, al-insan, and your fitrah is nasiya. You always keep on forgetting. And that's why Allah said, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind each other, because reminding each other always bring benefit to people who are believers. The Prophet ﷺ said, لَا تَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ. Because the only thing that can qualify us to enter Jannah is iman. Not your car, not your job, not your office, not your iman. And iman cannot be collective. Oh, my father, he is a mufti. I'm okay. Because my father recommend me to go to Jannah. No. You can be a mufti. Even the Prophet Noah cannot save his son. Prophet Lut cannot save his wife. Cannot save his. Because everybody must save their own soul. And the only thing can save your soul is with iman. And the Prophet said, La tadkhuluna al-jannah. La tadkhuluna al-jannah. None of us can enter paradise. Hatta tu'minu. Until you have iman. Until you believe in Allah. Without iman, you cannot enter paradise. But I'm the president, even you are a president. Even you are king, but you cannot enter paradise without iman. And then the Prophet continued, وَلَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُّوا. حَتَّى تَحَابُّوا. You cannot be a believer until you love one another. Now, how do you love one another? Do you love one another? Do you love your brothers Muslim? Do you love each other sisters? Inshallah. Shake your head. I need some reaction. Do you love each other? Yes. Don't say no. I know maybe it's your culture. This also yes, this also no. Our culture, yes is like this. This one is no. So always remember. If you said you love each other, and if you want Allah to love you, do you want Allah to love you? I don't hear you. Alhamdulillah. Yes, your voice is important. We need your voices. The Prophet asked all of us, Awala adullukum. Awala adullukum. Ala shay'in. Iza fa'altumuh tahabbtum. The Prophet asking us, shall I not tell you of that which will strengthen your love between yourself? The Prophet is asking us, do you want to know how can you strengthen your love among yourself? Do you want to know? Do we want to know? Yes. Alhamdulillah. If you say no, I keep quiet. I go to another topic. But since you said you want to know, the Prophet said, Afsus salam bainakum. Afsus salam bainakum. Spread the word of peace, the greeting of Islam among yourself. One thing I want you to do for the sake of Allah, brothers and sisters, for the sake of Allah, not because of me. Now you are sitting so close to each other. Please hold your hand. Hold your hand, each other, for the sake of Allah. Hold your hand. Feel the heat. Feel the iman is coming true. The iman is coming true. It's sure to come true because you do for the sake of Allah, not for the sake of anybody. The sisters, hold your hand. It's very strange. You are sitting beside your sister. You do not know her. You don't even care to say, Assalamualaikum, brother. You don't even say that. And you don't even say to them, I love you for the sake of Allah, Now this is what I want to say for the sake of Allah, so that Allah will strengthen your love. Say salam to your right. Say salam. Say salam to the left. When you give salam, you must see each other. Now everybody is facing and they don't see each other. Tell your brother, I love you for the sake of Allah. Say to him. Say to him. Say to each other, Allah. Allah will love you today more, brothers and sisters. Each time when you love something for the sake of Allah, when you love somebody for the sake of, don't keep it in your heart. Yeah, I love him. You love your husband. Tell him every day, I love you, darling. Tell him. And if your husband love your wife, tell her, I love you, darling. Yes, I love you. When? Before married. Before married, I love you. After married, what is love? Now we are husband and wife. What do you need love? Na'uzubillah. The Prophet, when he loves somebody, he always said to the person, I love you for the sake of Allah. I love you for the sake of Allah. Because the Prophet said, if you say this to somebody, then Allah is going to love him more. And that person will say back to you, Habakallah allazi habbabtani li aji. May Allah love you more because Allah just loved me more because of what you said just now. So by keep on saying this good word, Allah will strengthen the love among us. When you have that love, you save your iman. Iman is based on love. And that's why if you love something or somebody more than Allah, you commit shirk fi muhabba. It's a shirk. It is a shirk. And if you commit shirk, Allah said, innahu may yushrik billah faqad harram Allah alayhi al-jannah wa ma'wahu an-nar. Indeed, anyone, if you commit shirk with Allah, whether shirk in aqidah, shirk in ibadah, shirk in niyat, shirk in muhabba, then Allah said, you will never enter paradise. And when you don't enter paradise, Allah said, your destination is nar. And you will never be helped by anybody. Nobody can help you over there. Here, somebody can help you. Your brother can help you. Your wife can help you. Your husband can help you. Your children can help you. The most important thing, you must love each other